It's a moment I will never forget, when Diana kissed me on the cheek and said goodbye in the aptly titled The Forget-Me-Not. Immediately afterwards, I returned to my dressing room and cried. I just knew that I was going to miss her so much. She'd been everything, her energy, her sense of fun. To paraphrase Rex Harrison, I'd grown accustomed to her face and loved it. Goodbye, and I'm going to miss you, which is entirely from her. She generates this. Yeah, there she is.
Always keep your bowler on.
Makes you cry before you even...
Watch out, diabolical monster.
No, it's incredible.
I'll remember.
Goodbye, Steve.
Isn't that incredible? That's what makes you cry.
Emma.
She's beautiful. The door, yes. Lovely moment.
Lovely moment.
But that was entirely generated from her. I didn't have anything to do with that at all. She turned on, did it from her own guts.
Darling Patrick, the strongest memory I have of those years we spent together was your wonderful ability to make me laugh. When things were at their grimmest, and we were behind schedule, and the scripts weren't right, and all sorts of things were going wrong, you used to say something and off we'd go, didn't you? The other thing which, to my great joy, stemmed from our relationship was a very deep affection which has survived all the intervening years.
Yeah.
Much, much love.
Thank you, Diana Rigg.
Thank you, BAFTA, for this wonderful award. What I'm about to say may not be politically correct, but I know I owe it, to a very large degree, to a man, and that man is Patrick Macnee. He was in the series from the beginning. He was its linchpin. And he vigilantly upheld the standards and style of the Avengers, in addition to which he was the dearest and most generous of actors to work with. So thank you, BAFTA, very much. I'm sorry I can't be there. And a big thank you to darling Patty Nee.
divided, is it, dear? We're inseparable.